It's getting spicy right off the bat. I can't wait to analyze all this. Yo, what's good, guys? It's Robert for you. I'm again back with a new video. Today, we're going to talk about Minecraft Legends, a promising new action title, which is set to be released in 2023. Today, we got our hands on so much more information from both the official Minecraft YouTube channel, as well as Gamescom, a massive game event. And they talked a lot about Minecraft Legends. I am very excited to talk about pretty much everything you can find in these videos and also speculate a little bit of what we can expect at the release date, talk about things I really look forward to, but also discuss some things that do worry me regarding other titles of the Minecraft universe. Without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's get right to it. Yeah, we've got two new videos to talk about. Basically, the first one, which got posted only 13 hours ago, was a Minecraft Legends gameplay overview from Gamescom 2022. So the event which is going on right now, which reveals so much more information about the game. But first, we want to talk about the Minecraft Legends Fiery Foes official trailer, of course, from the official Minecraft YouTube channel. So let's check him out. See what we can find.
What is my favorite legend of the overworld? The one I like most tells of a peaceful land that did not know cruelty.
It's getting spicy right off the bat.
Until it was attacked by invaders.
By the way, I will talk about everything after watching this one. But boy oh boy, the vibe already is strong, guys. And baby creepers, ladies and gentlemen. Oh yeah. I can't wait to analyze all this.
Of struggles and sacrifices.
Yo. I still can't get used to the shell shading.
This legend reminds us that hope can win the day.
Hope can win the day, guys. Remember that. We've got hope for everything. Oh, well. These little swinesies don't look happy though. It needs legends, guys. Remember, you are legends. So, okay, that was it. Let's get back to the creeper things. So, this was already a pretty cute one. I absolutely love the baby piglins. Yeah, they are just clumsy, small. They have, like, cute little eyes. They don't look very dangerous, but they still have big maces, which they use to come after you. But they're just gonna squeak and run away. They're not gonna be very harmful, I guess. But, of course, at the end of the trailer, we saw some pretty crazy mobs popping up. Anyways, here we charge in, guys. And we've got the baby creepers in the front. Of course, you don't want to be in the blast radius. But how epic would this be? I think it's already missed opportunity since they are releasing this with Minecraft Legends. How epic would it be if we had like baby creepers on the official Minecraft as well? Also, maybe for dungeons. Like very small, like a baby zombie, very small threat that just runs straight towards you and then boom, it's gonna make your day terrible, especially if you're playing on hardcore. But yeah, let's continue. So we also have these baby zombie villagers, I think. Well, they're pretty small. Maybe everything is going to look baby-ish. I don't know. Baby archers or whatever you want to call them. Like these guys are pretty epic. So a little bit further in the trailer, we get this. And man, I am super excited for this. Let me know in the comments what you think these bad boys are going to be called. I mean, we already had brute piglins. In the previous trailers, they looked pretty scary. But these guys, ladies and gentlemen, they can roll. They are like Sonic the Hedgehog or just very scary looking. And I think they're going to be interesting. Basically, the frontliners that are just going to roll in there and going to destroy a big portion of your army, I guess. But yeah, that's what the trailer suggests. Anyways, that is basically it for the trailer. Not too much of gameplay to talk about. So let's move on to the Gamescom video, which reveals so much more. Boy, oh boy, I can't wait to talk about this.
Hey guys, but before we do, I should introduce... Not piglins.
So the executive producer, and a creative director. So they're going to talk about a lot of information, which we're going to analyze right now. Of course, if you are hyped for Minecraft Legends, say hype in the comments. But you can, of course, check out this entire video yourself. Link will be in the description. But of course, you don't have to, as we're going to analyze pretty much everything in this video right now. So let's just continue with all this and get to the first bits of gameplay. So right here, we can already see the vast lands of Minecraft Legends. And I absolutely love this shot, even though I'm still not getting used to the shell-shaded graphics. I mean, I kind of feel that this is something of a past time. It used to be cool with Borderlands, with older PlayStation titles. Yeah, it just looks a little bit strange in comparison with Minecraft Dungeons, which had like very nice lighting effects made with Unreal Engine. And then this basically looks a little bit like a downgrade. But what I do absolutely love right here is that the baby piglins are basically walking through the plains. And as you can see, they're basically moving around the vegetation. So if they're walking through, you can see the plants vibing around. And this is something which we haven't seen before. So the world is a little bit more dynamic. It's not going to be all static. And then you also have these little guys climbing over the rock, which is a pretty nice detail. So they are adding some pretty cool new details to the game, which we haven't seen before. And right here, we also have a fort. So this is one of the things that you have to conquer, of course, with different types of mobs. But you're basically going to recruit your army, rally them from different locations, and then you're gonna storm the keep to achieve victory on your quest. So this is a pretty interesting one. Right here you can see that the player is basically deciding where your troops are gonna be attacking. So you're just gonna drag and drop a pinpoint, and that will lead your mobs to it. So you see the blue circles around your allies, the yellow circles around the enemies, and the player is basically selecting a tower, and the entire army is gonna start storming that one when you release the button, let's say. And of course, you want to back off a little bit yourself with your horse, as you are the commander of your army. You don't want to die. I think when you die, it basically ends. So they're storming the tower, dealing a lot of damage, and probably when it's taken down, you will weaken their fortress. Right here, we can see exactly the same. Baby piglins going after it, and right at the moment when the tower fell, when it got toppled, basically, then we saw this red cloud popping up, which of course indicates that something happened to the reinforcement, something happens to the strength of this construction. So this outpost is weakened, and in this next shot, we've got another one. So we will probably get like a huge fortress somewhere on the world or the level, while there are going to be different smaller outposts scattered around the map, which you're going to have to deal with first to basically weaken the fortress and also recruit some new allies or save them basically to possibly get some more team members in your army or unlock some new powers. Because right here, if we look a little bit further with a couple of flames, then we actually have a sort of golden lock right in front of this little cage that they're taking down. And there are mobs inside there. It's pretty difficult to determine what's inside, but it looks like there's some kind of villagers like screaming like, help, get me out. And yeah, they're bashing through this to set them free, basically. So right here, guys, after quite some talking, we get another very interesting shot. So this, in the left, we have some pylons with basically holograms of the different mobs, which the character probably released or freed from the outpost. So we've got the little golems and also those arrow buckets. Let me know in the comments what you think they're going to be called. But I think the small ones are like just little golems. And then the other ones, they look like buckets. And through their noses, they shoot arrows. But they are sitting, like the holograms are sitting on top of this pylon with flames. And the character is also wearing this on the side of his horse. So it's probably a means of summoning in the creatures. Maybe you have to do this via the pylons. But basically, it's going on horseback towards the portal. And then this triggers a cutscene. I think the graphics are a little bit off, though. The cinematics look beautiful, while this looks pretty simple. And there we have the piglin brood basically commanding the army to strike, to charge in. All these little baby piglins with their bases. But then the player also decides to go in with his army. So here we go. Gate closes. He decides to attack the gate. So first the golems, then the buckets with the arrows. And you can also see that if he walks back, then all the mobs will follow him. So you can also retreat if you think things are a little bit too sticky, a little bit too much trouble, too much heat, let's say. You can also run back. So maybe if you don't have enough reinforcements, yeah, you can just call it a day, go back to the overworld, search for more outposts in the area, and recruit even more members for your army to actually have a greater force and a higher chance, of course, of taking down the gates to basically claim victory on the level.
Common in strategy games, you usually control a strategy game by a mouse pointer or something like that.
Right.
One thing that we wanted to do from the beginning is to make a strategy game that works well on console.
Right.
This is a very important thing, guys. They want to make a strategy game that works well on console. I love to play RTS, real-time strategy, and I only do this on PC because it's super difficult to make it work properly on console because you need all those macros, those extra key bindings. A mouse makes it a lot easier to select troops, let's say, but they're trying to make this interesting for console. And as you can see with all the controls, it does look pretty simple. So you're basically using your joystick to select a certain area, then your army is going to run towards it. They're going to take it down. And if you run back with your horse, basically, then you will also alarm your army about the fact that you actually want to retreat. So they will automatically follow you again. And the combat for you personally is going to be pretty simple. You're just going to be on horseback, slashing with your sword, while the army is going to take care of the rest. So once again, he's retreating a little bit. Army is going back as well. And then he's using the flag like, guys, we're going to keep pushing on. And they continue with the combat. Wow, bro, look at this though, at the back. Oh, this was chaotic. You see all those little piggies. There's so many of them behind the gates. That's, look at this, man. Once they break through, it's gonna be total chaos. But yeah, it looks really cool. Right here, we've got this menu. So if you press on a certain button, you can basically highlight everything that's going on. I absolutely love this. It's very simple to see which are the enemies, which are your allies, what your objective is. You have these two towers lighting up. They become red basically as well as the gate. So you know that's the objective to focus on. And right here, we also see something interesting popping up, which is new basically to the Minecraft universe. Bam! Exactly right there, we get like a totem with these magma spike cube kind of things. And it seems like depending on time, this thing goes down and down. So you actually want to break it as quick as possible. If you fail to do so, it explodes. Look at this, guys.
Having a hero at the center that can't be there.
Bam! Like, it's like... So I think you have to take this bad boy down as quick as possible. Otherwise, it's going to cause a massive explosion, dealing a lot of damage on the battlefield, which, of course, is going to injure your army members big time. There we've got another one. And it explodes and, dealing so much damage. I'm not sure if you should be staying close to that one. Actually exploded two times and his entire army got obliterated. So we're here, we've got another beautiful shot of the overworld. This is actually one which we saw in an earlier trailer. Once again, the shell-shaded graphics basically take over the vibe which we get from this environment. I think the nature looks cool. In the distance, we've got some pretty nice swamp or jungle trees, but the black lines, they are so dominant. I'm not really sure what to think of it, but who knows? I'm going to actually enjoy these graphics a lot. We basically played Don't Starve together as well. In the beginning, it took me a lot of time to get used to those graphics, but right now I absolutely love the style. And if we look at this scene, guys, seriously, this is just breathtaking. We've got these beautiful jungle trees and also some mushrooms even growing on top of them. This blue scenery. Yeah, I absolutely love this vibe, which is created. But that's just only one of the many sceneries. Right here, we've got a pretty interesting image about ocelots chasing the player, as well as llamas. They look pretty cute, like baby llamas. Who knows, they might fight with us, but I am not really sure if the llamas are going to be dealing a lot of damage, as in Minecraft, they also spit. But that's not very scary. And
which gives you an instant speed...
Speed wheat, which gives you an instant speed boost.
Mushrooms within the world, which allows you to jump extra high.
Or there is going to be mushrooms that allow you to jump extra high. But yeah, let's just go back a couple frames, as right here we basically see that the player is placing down some chests, and inside those chests we will have our workers, or the gatherers basically, who gather the resources which we're gonna need for the building, which we're gonna see in the next shot. So right here, he places three of those, removing this tree, gathering the resources. Next shot, exactly the same. And then we move on to the building, which we also saw a very short amount of frames of in a previous video. But the player is basically placing down a gate. So I used to think that the building was going to be very simple. It's just going to be you choosing a template, make the keep pop up at location X, and bam, that's done. But it's actually so much more. So I am pretty excited about this. So the player is deciding a location to place down the gate. And then the player is basically dropping down some towers, and after that he's connecting these with the wall. So you're gonna have to do all the building yourself. Of course, it's gonna be pretty limited. You won't be able to choose a wall color and make gates through that. I think there's gonna be some basic fortress elements like a wall, a gate, a tower, and then of course also the main base or building, which you can see the very center of it, once again including those holograms which we saw a little bit earlier for both the golem and also the arrow bucket. And look at that, we've got some pretty small baby piggies popping up as well. But yeah, I am really looking forward to the building, guys. Definitely let me know in the comments what you think about it, what it's going to be like. But this is of course so much more information we can speculate about.
Dungeons, Minecraft Dungeons, taught so much to the art organization on to how to bring a new game to the players. And like, I personally think we learned so much just from that game alone that we're applying to Legends to make sure that we can bring another game in the right way.
This is a pretty interesting one. They say they learned so much about the development of Legends, also with Minecraft Dungeons, as it was an entirely different game genre with the same universe, of course, and they had some difficulties they had to work with. But in the end, it turned out to become a pretty good game, and right now they're trying to take all this experience onto the development for Minecraft Legends. I do fear a little bit, though, that...
make sure that we can bring another game in the right way.
So, another game in the right way. I find this one the most interesting, as Minecraft Dungeons isn't a bad game. And let's just quickly talk about this, because I still think it's a good game. The problem is, though, that the replay value is missing. So at a certain point, if you've played through all the difficulties, if you reach like the highest Apocalypse Plus, got your hands on the best weapons and armor, there is basically no replay value, and the game becomes repetitive, eventually boring. You don't care about cosmetics, you don't care about anything, you just want to have more gameplay. And development-wise, I don't see many improvements being made to the game to cater, let's say, the people who have been playing it for a while right now. I really want to say this. I hope they listen to that. But this is something they probably learned from. And right now, they should add replay value to Minecraft Legends, because if they don't, well, it's going to become a pretty boring game very fast. While with Minecraft, you have so much replay value. They keep updating the game, all the updates are basically free. While I kind of fear that if they take the same path like they did with Minecraft Dungeons, focus a little bit on monetization, every time when there is like new levels popping up, you have to pay for the DLC. I really fear that might happen, but of course it doesn't mean it's gonna happen, but definitely things to think about. So guys, let me know your thoughts in the comments. I would very much appreciate it, and who knows, the developers will read it as well.
It's not about getting stronger, or you're not getting a new arm or anything like that.
Yeah.
It's more or less...
Ah, too bad. No character customization. No new armor, no new weapons. Would it be pretty cool, though, if you can, like, get your hands on a new mount, or find an awesome weapon, like, instead of constantly fighting with the diamond sword. How awesome would it be if you could use a whip from Minecraft Dungeons, like, just smack them piggies. Or use a spear to have a thrust attack from long range. So many missed opportunities, in my opinion, but hey, it does sound very nice for the rest of it. So I'm kind of looking forward to testing this game. Who knows, it's going to be a very nice one. This right here is also a pretty cool shot. Once again, storming the fortress, guys. And of course, making sure that his allies start attacking the gate. But as you can see, the character is wearing a different skin right here. So that is going to be some kind of character customization once again. So you can probably customize your horse, customize the skin of your character. I personally would love it if they finally implement something that allows you to connect your Minecraft skin to the Minecraft Legends character. The same is missing for Minecraft Dungeons. It would be very awesome if you can just upload your skin to the Xbox cloud and then it's going to be on all the different platforms. But who knows, that's something they are working on. Would be very awesome to see that. So now we basically get some shots which we've already covered a little bit earlier in this video. They're basically replaying every single one of them. Every now and then we do see some new player or mount skins popping up. But I think that's basically everything we could talk about today. Wow, that was a lot of information. Whew. Anyways, guys, if you think I missed something, let me know in the comments down below. I would love to make a video for it in the future. Right now, though, I want to hear your thoughts. What do you think about Minecraft Legends? Will it be a successful title? What are your doubts about it? If not, what do you think is going to be great? We can keep speculating, and I'm just really looking forward to hearing what you guys think. Anyways, right now, I want to thank every single one of you for watching. Make sure to hit that like button if you enjoyed watching this one. Of course, support the channel big time, as well as subscribing if you want to stay in the loop with all the future content for Legends. Guys, I want to wish you an awesome day. I'll see you very soon. Take care. Peace.